Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to TokenPost's interview. Today, we have invited Ms. Anna Rosebrook, the head of business development in Changelly. Welcome.
Yeah, thank you.
So, could you give a brief introduction about yourself and what Changelly is?
Yeah, so I do business development for Changelly. We are already 3 years on the market. So, we have over 2 million registered users and lots of partners like Economy, Jux, Exodus have just implemented our API, Particle, as you've mentioned before. So CoinMarketCap is one of our biggest affiliates. We have a wide range of partners using our API. So once we want to collaborate with a project that has its own token, and we list this project, this token on our platform, we ask about using our API into their one. So it's some kind of ecosystem of lots of partners using our service.
So when it comes to Changelly, it's not just an exchange, right? It uses a bot to locate the most optimal trades or changes. So could you explain a little bit about that?
Yeah, so what we do is we check the best trades from already existing market. It's Poloniex, Bittrex, HitBTC or Binance. Mm-hmm. And we make we trade on behalf of our client. Mm-hmm. So it means that the rates that you will see on our main website or maybe on the widget or through the API with our partners, these are the rates from the exchanges, mm-hmm. one of the biggest ones. And we charge our own fee and it's only 0.5%. Mm-hmm. You could trade crypto to crypto and that's it.
So you guys are currently not holding funds. You guys don't deal with fiat currencies. You guys don't hold the customers' assets. So does that conflict with regulations or any part of that?
We don't hold any assets from. We don't have our own wallet. Mm-hmm. What we do is we provide the address where to send the funds. Mm-hmm. As soon as we receive the funds from the user, we send from our corporate account from, let's say, Binance. Mm-hmm. So it means that we don't hold anything from you. Mm-hmm. So the trade is made like this. As for the regulation, we have different jurisdictions, like mm-hmm. We have the company in Czech Republic, that's mm-hmm. where we started our company, and now we have also in Hong Kong, mm-hmm. and we think about Malta too.
So you are the head of business development, and you are currently in Asia. So which part of the Asian market that best like suits your eye? Where you're targeting?
It's a good question because we see great potential in Japanese market. Mm-hmm. We see lots of big volume transactions.
Yes.
As we don't ask any NQIC, we don't ask. We ask at the moment only the email trade.
The email address. Yeah. Yes.
Only an email address, and then you could go through. We ask the KYC only for untraceable currencies because, it is important for all the community. Mm-hmm. So the Japanese market is very interesting to us, maybe Korean. Yeah, we are here. All the Asian, we are searching for big projects. Mm-hmm. We don't like, okay, let's go to Japan and take the best of it. We are work worldwide.
We are open.
We are searching for good community for the project.
So project wise, when it comes to blockchain, there's like a lot of types. Like there's real estate, insurance, trades, finance, all of that. So I heard that you are managing token listing. So to your part, which shows priority when it comes to project, like, categorizing?
So The first, our main requirement is the technical requirement. It's not about the project, what kind of it. It should be listed on one of the exchanges that we trade on. So I to repeat, it's Poloniex, Bittrex, HitBTC, and Binance. We can't list any token on our platform without it being having a good market on one of these exchanges. So then we check the community, how it is active, how many users do they have in there. It's not only about the token holders, it's about the whole community. Maybe if they will have their wallet or some kind of the project, how they will operate daily in their everyday life, this this project.
So you also support ICO projects as well, if at if given that they are listed on exchange partnership exchanges, as you mentioned?
Once the ICO is finished, once they are listed on one of the exchanges, the project is welcome to apply to get listed with us. But to tell you the truth, we have around 500 applications. Sorry, me, I could it could take some time for me to check the project for the whole team to make the decision.
So if a project were to interested in like getting partnership with you, how would they get to like how would they contact you?
So the you
I'm asking like if there's any like application formats.
So the we have an application form on our main website. You may want to go to our main website directly, and at the bottom you will see add your token. Yeah, and then it's
simple as that.
So it's a form, and you could download our presentation about what kind of service we provide to the projects. Because after that you apply to the form. After you contact me, you will find my personal contacts in that form. So welcome to write me and ping me every time. Okay, Anna Rosebrook, please check our. But yeah, actually, the main thing is to collaborate with us. You may want to offer us money, but it's not what we what we do really need. We are searching for community, for collaboration, how you will use our service in the future. Maybe it will be the widget, API, or you will promote us to Japanese market. So that's what we are interested in.
So lastly, I want to ask you, what is your take on the Korean crypto community? How is it going? What's your take on it so far?
So it's very interesting here. It's very useful for me because I do personally like the Asian market. Our CEO was focused on the States. Now when I came back from first from China, then from other parts of Asia, I feel okay. It's a great market for us. So that's why. And here I see lots of interesting projects and our partners that I've talked previously only online.
I hope you find a good partner here in Korea and Japan in the Asian market overall.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your time. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in. That was Miss Anna Rosebrook, the head of business development of Changelly. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Mike.
Thank you so much.